Takiyah Ahmad-Yankowy says the welcoming service at her spot feels like a mother's hug, and you can really feel the love in each dish. For Thai food in a plant-filled space, she heads to Coco Thai Bistro in Narberth.
When guests come here for the first time, they will probably be wowed by all the plants that are in the restaurant.
In the beginning, I walk in here, I thought it was flower shop. When I got first interview, I'm like, is this a restaurant or a flower shop?
Yes.
And I'm like, I'm in the wrong place.
Here at Coco Thai Bistro, our style is Thai fusion. A lot of our recipes came from the owners and developed along with the chefs here, tailored with the customer's palate in mind. We place an emphasis on healthy options that customers can customize.
They should try curry. All different four type of curry. Red, green, musliman, and penang is the best. Because I'm the one who make it.
We want customers to feel comfortable when they're dining here. We want them to leave feeling that they've spent good quality time bonded over food together. Food that's made with love.
Takiyah. This place is so homey. Tell us why you picked Coco Thai Bistro.
I picked Coco Thai Bistro because, just like you said, when you eat it, it's like a mother's hug from the inside out. So you get a hug on the inside because the food is so delicious. It's so pleasant. It's small. It's a beautiful place to go. When you walk in, it's like going into a restaurant in the middle of the horticultural center. They have plants everywhere. They're not like a lot of vibrant colors, but it's a lot of life because you have all these plants and this delicious food and these smells, and you can't go wrong. Whatever dish you decide to pick is going to be the right dish. All of the food there is delicious, so that's why I picked Coco Thai.
For a recent lunch, you kept it light with some lemongrass soup.
I kept it light with the lemongrass soup, and I had some chicken added to it. And the soups there are very light. Even if you go with the coconut soup, the base is very light. You get just the right amount of flavor. And you also can tell that you're eating something that's good for your body. It feels healthy and flavorful all at the same time.
Chip, you started off your meal with some shrimp dumplings, which you say are the best.
They are the best dumplings I've ever had. They were incredible. They had a little bit of spinach in it, which I thought was great, made me feel a little healthy, and I could have eaten them for my entire meal.
I didn't go light. I went with four appetizers. I went with the dumpling sampler. I did the jasmine rice soup. I did the Thai coconut soup.
How was the coconut soup?
It was really good. As Takiyah was saying, it was very light. And it was full of flavor. So that was the one thing that I found throughout all the dishes, is that it really tastes like home cooking.
I know, Atsuko, you got some curries for your table. How were they?
Again, it had a lot of flavor. It felt home cooked. The one thing that I will say is I didn't think it was as savory as I'm used to. It was a lot sweeter. It might have been because we didn't ask for the right spice level. The portion was pretty large that we could share it among the three of us. And again, it tasted like somebody in the back was cooking for home.
How was your Thai basil?
The Thai basil is delicious as always. Every dish you get from Coco Thai Bistro is layered. So as you're eating it, you get layers of flavor. So whether it's in the curry that you're tasting, you can taste the different spices in the curry. You can taste the different spices that were used on the chicken or the fish or the shrimp or whatever you get added to it. Because with every dish, you have your choice of keeping it as a vegetarian meal, or you can add some protein, as in meat protein. So you can add chicken, shrimp, fish. You can also add tofu. But you can taste all the flavors. You taste everything in the bowl.
Chip, how were your entrees?
The entrees were incredible. I went back twice, and I had the drunken noodles, which is always a nice quality meal for me, and it was amazing. It was great. I had the chicken drunken noodles. They were great. And then I went back, and I had one of the specials, which was a quinoa dish, which it was really, it was surprising. I love quinoa, and they did it amazingly. It was shrimp and crab meat mixed in, and there was a healthy amount of shrimp and crab meat, so I was really pleased with it.
So you have been to Narberth before.
I have. Right, so it was so nice to get out of the city for a while. I love South Philly, and we stick right around that neighborhood a lot, but it was nice to get out of the city. But I had forgotten that I had been to Narberth. My father used to deliver bread along the main line, and when we were little kids, we'd go along and help sometimes in the summer just for fun. And he would deliver to a lot of those restaurants right along that little stretch, you know, the little town. So I forgot. Until I was there for about a half hour walking around, I realized that some of those same stores and restaurants are there. And it's such a neat little town. I felt like I was on a little two-hour vacation out of the city. Like, it just, you're still basically in the city, but yeah. It was just such a nice, quaint little area.
It was like that. It was like a little vacation reprieve. Got in my car, and I was thinking, oh, where am I going? Oh, this is so cute. There are a lot of stores, restaurants, and Coco Thai is a BYOB, which I didn't actually anticipate or check beforehand, but they pointed me in the direction and said, you know, there's beer over there, there's wine over there, go out and help yourself. And so I had a look around, and it's cute. It's a really cute area.
How was the service? They recommended that you go out and, you know.
They were very welcoming and similar to the style of cooking. Like you said, I asked for something and they just, you know, they were quick to show me what to do. So it was very, very sweet.
The food came out so fast that I couldn't believe how fast it was. And they were so friendly. The first time I was in there, I was wearing a t-shirt from a 10K that I ran. And because I'm not a fancy person, so that's what I showed up to the restaurant wearing. And the waitress was so complimentary. She's like, oh, you ran a 10K. That's wonderful. And she made me feel like such an athlete as I'm shoveling dumplings into my face. But I'm a pretty good athlete. So they were great. They were so friendly and so welcoming. And I just love the space too. Like, it just feels warm. And I was trying to figure out that back area too, which isn't exactly the kitchen, but it is, and it feels, I mean, just with all the greens back there, it does feel like you're in a greenhouse, but it just, the whole place felt welcoming.
Takiyah, Coco Thai Bistro is your pick. Sum it up for us.
So Coco Thai Bistro is the perfect little spot that you can go to get a delicious, healthy meal so that you don't feel like you're just eating all health and no meal. And you can also take the family or use it as a date night and be selfish like my husband and I.
Chip, sum it up for us.
It was a really nice surprise for me. The food was delicious, and I think just the overall feel of the restaurant itself was so comfortable, and the little neighborhood, it was amazing.
Atsuko, sum up your experience at Coco Thai Bistro.
If you're looking for an alternative to the city and looking for a little vacation spot, it's great. And also as an alternative to other Asian foods like Chinese, it's a great way to be introed to it.
Make a reservation for yourself at Coco Thai Bistro, located at 231 Haverford Avenue in Narberth, Pennsylvania, 610-667-7634. They're open for dinner 7 days a week and lunch Tuesdays through Sundays. Reservations are accepted, and the average tab per person is $20.